Hello, and welcome to the Exponential Smoothing tutorial series. In our last few tutorials, we discussed how to construct one or multiple steps out of a sample forecast and the calibration process for the smoothing parameters for simple exponential smoothing. Now, we will demonstrate how to calculate a fitted or in-sample forecast. But first, let's discuss what an in-sample forecast is and how it is different from an out-of-sample forecast. The in-sample forecast refers to forecasting an observation that was part of the data sample used to calibrate the model. So it's not really a forecast, more like a model-fitted value. For the sample data, we'll continue using the sales data of a hypothetical company from the last 2 years. First, select the E9 cell and type in the simple exponential function name equals SESMTH, open parentheses. Once you find the function, click on the FX button found on the left side of the equation toolbar. This will invoke the function arguments dialog box for the simple exponential smoothing function. For the input data, select the whole cell range corresponding to the sales data, which is C9 to C33. Lock the cell range by pressing F4. For the time order in the input data, type in true or 1 to designate the first observation as the earliest observation. For the alpha value, select the cell in D1. The value in D1 was calculated during the calibration using the first year subset as a training set. Lock the cell reference by pressing F4 and leave the optimization switch disabled by referencing cell D2. Lock this cell reference by pressing F4. For forecast time, type in or select a cell with a value equal to the number of steps past the end of the data to include. For return type, type in 2 for one step in sample forecast series. Then click OK. The function returns the first value in the array. To display the whole array, select all the cells below, then press F2 to edit. Then press Ctrl, Shift, and Enter. The selected cells are now populated with the array values and the formula is italicized. Now let's plot the in-sample forecast against our data and compute the different forecast performance measures. As we can see, the in-sample forecast performs worse than out-of-sample, but this is okay, as we would sacrifice in-sample forecast accuracy for good generalization and a better out-of-sample forecast. That's all for now. Thank you for watching.